did you do it? Do you visit all the provinces, or do you start with vote-rich provinces? A senator told me, one of those who once said, Karen, it's actually just knowing where to go, because you have some provinces, 2 million votes. You know, so some of them don't go to the really smaller ones. What did you do?
No, it doesn't matter. We went to the places where we felt we can reach out to more people, like places with a media center, okay. For example, that they can gather there and then get your statement. It's really important, because even if you wanted, Senator Cheese would always say this, even if you wanted to shake everybody's hands, you can't really do that.
Yeah.
So you need also the help of radio, you need the help of the local papers.
Nuh-uh.
So these things, you should be covered at least when you go to those areas.
Okay. Now, since it's after elections anyway, how much money did you start with? Because I remember, meron pa pong Grace po donation. Remember, no? Talagang humihingi siya ng donation from ordinary people.
Yeah, hindi naman. Lugawan.
Meron Lugawan. Lugawan. Oh,
and that was not my idea.
Okay, go ahead.
That was more like my MTRCB
friends.
But for me, it's important also that the citizenry would take an active role, parang having a stake in your campaign.
Uh-oh.
Diba? Because at least they feel that they're a part of it, they feel that they have the right to be able to tell you what they advocate for also. In the States, it's like that.
Yes.
Obama gets from
Facebook, Twitter,
Facebook,
everything.
Because
yes.
It's a democracy, so you want active citizenry participation.
Oh, so may lugawan ka.
Meron akong lugawan. It was good naman. But how much money did I start with? I would admit that the money that I started with actually came from
friends.
No, from my dad's company.
Oh.
And my mom.
Okay.
That's why I also wanted some support, diba, as much as possible.
Yeah. Oh.
But I felt comfortable. The point was, if nobody donated, and I think I mentioned this to you.
Yeah.
When my mom said, "Okay, get into it," we already sort of made a plan. What if nobody donates to you?
Uh-oh.
We will run a really lean campaign, but at least we will still be able to have some ads, but not
correct.
The way that we had it.
Okay. Now, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, when he ran independent, admitted that he just had a budget of 60 million
yeah.
pesos, and Sharon Cuneta, of course, and Casey, and won. He
yes.
did that whole independent truck thing. How much did Grace Poe spend? Give us a ballpark figure.
I think it's about close to that also that he mentioned.
Only?
Or like mga 70, maybe, yeah.
Ang swerte mo naman with ads. Naka number one ka sa 70 million?
Or baka less, ha?
No way.
Oh, look, okay.
Really?
Don't quote me, but yes, I think it's something like that, because it will be public record anyway.
Anyway, yes.
Because my husband is the one that looks at the books for this, because
yes,
I don't
course.
Have time for it. But it's just about that. I mean, it's not just.
Yeah,
I mean, that's
yes.
a lot of money.
No, but I know some of your colleagues that have spent $150 million on advertising. Some of them had reached $200.
Really?
Some, yeah, like $140. I think on the record is, I think, Jack and Riley at one point.
Yeah. Well,
because
I don't
of
know.
Late, the advertising already on television, it's so expensive. You only spent roughly $70?
That's what I remember.
Wow.
Okay, look, I mean, it's
yeah.
being updated every day.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it just stopped, like, what, yesterday or the other day?
Uh-oh.
But that's what I remember.
Okay, now, does Grace po, may utang na loob ba si Grace po sa isang malaking negosyante?
Alam mong, awa ng Diyos. May mga tumutulong sa akin. And every time naman they help, what they tell me is that we want the country to be better, and we would like new faces in the Senate. And then we've seen your track record. We've seen more or less. We can judge your character quite a bit. I mean, at this point, so that's how it is. And yes, I admit a lot of them are wealthy businessmen.
Mm, you need a lot of them.
Yes,
business,
not
really?
A lot of them, but a few of them. But they have their good reputations also to protect.
Mm-hmm. Very, okay. All right.
You know, no, right?
Of course.
You recommend yeah. some.
Now, this is what I wanted to ask you. The advertisements, Congressman Miro Kimbo did an analysis and said, your first advertisements were not as effective, but the Susan Roses advertisement was the best.
He said that?
Yeah. Well, I mean, they did some studies. Tell me
yeah.
what you...
Well, it started out with the... Po and Oppo, which I think,
which
I mean,
what do you think?
Effective, because for me, that's just an introduction for you to become like a a household name or, you know, kids would be like, Grace Poe, Grace Poe. Sabi ko nga, alam mo kung pwede lang bumoto itong mga batang to.
Really?
Panalo na ako eh. Kasi diba, Grace Poe, mano po. Or, you know, they'd always say, they like it. So the first one is introduction. Then the second one is like a, more like a feel-good advocacy with Carmina and also getting different people, farmer representation. But the last is the assurance. Diba? It's my mom.
Nga, galing.
Kasi diba, when you introduce, first you introduce a product, and then you show the nice thing about the product, and then you come out with an endorser that will assure you that this product is something that she can guarantee. And my mom has that credibility, I would say. Her many years in show business, her character, and then also she endorses products that are Filipino, the soap
medicine,
product and
yes.
the medicine. They're proudly Filipino, and then it also has good reputation. Those products also have a good reputation in the market.
Oh, so I think yung nanay mo na yung huli yung ano yun, wag mo kami, ano yun, wag mo pahiyain tatay mo.
And then, no, she says that to me in private, pero parang pagbutihan mo.
Oh.
You know the side story, of course, you know Bibeth and Carlitos, right?
Yes.
So there's a script naman. I mean, actually, I kind of drafted that speech.
Oh, you did?
Because it happened there.
Okay.
And then we had the copywriter to just put it also so that it will fit really in the 30-second or 15 seconds.
So you partly wrote that?
Of course.
TV commercial?
Because it really happened. Bakit ka tumatakbo? Of course, I mean, you know, bakit tumatakbo ng senador? And then explain. And this is my platform. So, of course, but the copywriter had to put it naman so that it would be something that would fit in the 15 seconds or the 30 seconds, right?
Uh-oh.
And then in the end, it was just supposed to be promise yan, ha? And then I'd say promise po. And then my mom was supposed to be done. Nagdagdag pagbutihan mo. And then so after that, sabi niya, direct, tignan mo na lang ha kung bagay. Kasi baka naman hindi. But then when they reviewed it, when they were doing the editing, pwede naman. So they kept it.
Oh, you know what's interesting is how history retells itself. Your commercial was reminiscent of Cory Aquino and Ninoy.
That was our peg.
Ninoy. That was your peg.
That was our peg.
Ano yun yung...
Lagot siya sa nanay niya.
Oo, lagot siya sa nanay. Pag hindi niya pinagbutihan, lagot siya sa nanay niya.
Oo.
That was your peg.
That was our peg. Because you see, not for anything, but the president also has more or less the same situation. He has two very loved and popular parents.
You're right.
And then initially, they also questioned his capabilities,
yes.
di ba? And his experience. But then, now that he's there in office, of course, nobody's perfect, right? But nobody can question his integrity. Diba? There may be some things lacking, but then compared to all the other presidents, I think he's doing rather well. And people's trust in the institutions are slowly being brought back.
Uh-oh.
So for me, if I can, you know, he's like my guide. Diba? He didn't destroy the name of his parents. So that's also what I hope. To be
yeah,
able to
actually,
achieve.
You're right. You do have, I mean, a similarity in your life stories.
Yeah.